are very delighted today to have with us His Grace Bishop Boules, Bishop of Kenya and many countries in Africa. He's a wonderful bishop, very simple, well-educated, and very active, not only in Africa, but in many countries all over the world. His Grace kindly, when I was sick, he sent me several messages, and he prayed for me, as well as he prayed for all his people. Your Grace, we are very delighted to have you with us today. It's a great honor to have you with us. Pray for us as well as we are going to pray for your ministry. Thank you.
Actually, I was so happy when I entered find Abuna Mikhail. Abuna Mikhail has long history, each church, and his love, his care for us from the time of Sayyidina al-Baba Shnuda. Always he is a father. And I tell him, "Ent mish priest, ent father, big father." And all of us praying for him, God to keep his health, his life, his great ministry here. And when I remember how much he achieved, what we do in Africa is very little. God keep him and bless him. I want to speak about the reading today. If you are like connected to the reading with each other, you find it speaks about door. In the epistle of St. Paul, 2 Corinthians chapter 2, St. Paul went to, he passed by Troas there, and there the door was open for him. But he couldn't stay. God opened the door for him to serve. But he couldn't stay. Because he said that my heart was troubled. Why? Because he was waiting Titus, his disciple. He sent him by a message to Corinth after a problem there, and St. Paul was correcting the problem, and they were not happy about that, and they sent very bad report to St. Paul about his character, his service. He was so sad. And it seemed he wrote another epistle to give them love and say, "I forgive what you did against me. But what I care now, your spiritual life and your future." And St. Paul was waiting Titus to come with a report, how is the Church of Corinth? And he was worried because the Church of Corinth, one of the biggest churches there, and he was worried if this church will be healthy or not, and loyal to the gospel or not. And so when he went to Rois there, and the door opened for him, God opened for him the door to serve. He couldn't. And he said, "My spirit was troubled." I will explain that later on. And he left to Macedonia. It seems he went to Philippi because people of Philippi love him and they find love and care there. Philippi was to St. Paul like Bethany for Jesus, Mary and Martha and Lazarus, a place of rest. So he went there. But here the gospel speaks about four friends, four beautiful people carrying their friend who is paralyzed, bring them to Jesus. But this time they found the door is closed. St. Paul found the door is open, but he didn't use it. But these four people found the door is closed. And all the time people ask me, "Sayyidina, what is the meaning door is opening and door is closed? What difference?" But if I find the door is closed, what can I do? When God closed the door, what happened always? Easy. I was in with a group of servants in Dubai 2 days ago, and one said to me, "When I said, Sayyidina, I found the door is closed," I say, "This is the will of God. I stop it." But what these four friends did was their paralyzed friend. Did they say, "Okay, give up"? No. All the time, God closed the lower doors to open higher doors for us. I like that very much. They said the lower door is closed, but God won't open our other door up. Remember that. Many times God shatter our dreams. Like as the Bible says, as Jesus said in John 15, he trims. He trimming, pruning us, cut something from us. Why? Because he wants something else to grow. I remember I brought a beautiful grape, Arfinel vine grapefruit, from there, Amba Samuel. And I was happy. And I planted it in the monastery in Kenya. And I'm waiting for grape. It didn't come. Till one of my friends was like a professor in agriculture. And he came to take care of all the plants in the monastery. And I asked him, he said, because Sayyidina, you didn't cut it. You should trim it, cut part of it. Because it took all its energy to expand, no energy now to bring fruits. And because we have a lot of distraction in our life, I'm so worried about distraction. We don't have this priority that God is first. My sitting with the Lord is first. My relationship with the Lord is first. Not to squeeze it with a lot of friends, relationships. Now I'm worried very much about relationships. The worst things happen to us through bad relationships. I hear that all the way in America. Relation, the devil send a friend which take our life down, which tempting us, which keep us dry. What we need, please go and close this door and open another door up. I said, instead to exhaust my energy in that relationship which is failure, which take me down, let take this time and give it to the Lord. God need me. I will be blessed. Not visible is the best. The visible is the worst. The invisible inside. And that is the life of faith. God want my heart. God want to put him prayer in my life. And say, Lord, you are first. I want you. I need you. I want to be always with you. I want to experience your joy, your presence. I don't want to be stressed or confused by relationships. But it's very strange that these four friends didn't give up. I like that. They said, we need to see Jesus. But the door is closed. No. God, when we love Jesus, God gave us creative ways to see him, to touch him. I come to the church in the liturgy to see him. And I come to take Holy Communion to see him. And all the time in my house, I have my Bible to see him. Don't give up. Don't live at the border. I'm afraid some people come to the church sinners and go out of the church sinners. While the mighty Savior is here, while he's waiting, while he's opening his arm to give every one of us rest. But we don't use that. These friends said, no, we need to see Jesus. But the door is closed. No. God will open another door. And God gives them the idea, let us knock the roof and bring our friend down. And what is strange, Taman? Everyone was complaining inside the house. Dust coming and these things coming. And everyone shouting, what's that? What you are doing? And Jesus was happy. Was not. While Jesus was like there and every dust coming, but he was happy. He saw their face. God wants to see our face. I'm coming to the church to be blessed. Believe me, I confess you. Take blessing of Abuna Mikhail for that. I'm afraid to come to the church because it is like a ritual. It's a habit. I should come and pray liturgy. I'm a bishop. If I wouldn't do that, people would say, Sayyidina is lazy. Sayyidina not spiritual. But that is the worst theology. I come and remind myself that I'm coming to meet the King. I need him. I need his love. I need to touch me from inside. I need to heal areas in my life. I need him to revive me. I need to give me promises. I need to give me hope for future. I need him. God has unlimited fresh foods for us to feed. He's the bread of life. So please don't come and sit in your place like that and sleep, or okay, tell the liturgy, no, come and receive, insist, I'm coming to be blessed, I'm coming to be changed, I need something to be changed, I need something to be healed, I need something to be corrected, I want the spirit to challenge me and make me better and more spiritual. They insist to bring him in front of Jesus. And when Jesus saw him, he didn't give him what he wants, but give him what he needs. Remember that. Jesus never gave us what we want. Because always what we want is the things of the world, our needs. Jesus doesn't care for our comfort. He cares more for our eternal life. So he said to him, what is important, what you need is not healing. What? I'm coming for healing. No. What you need is forgiveness of your sins. Remember, we look for outer things. We like outer things. I heard one say to me something funny. He said, we were wearing masks with everyone, even God himself. And God said, you do that, I will make you to wear the true mask to know what you are doing. We wear masks. We come to the church, smile, happy. But inside me, something not happy, something weak, something in the hand of the devil, something dark. I need Jesus to touch this one. Be honest. Be honest. Don't lose this chance. Nowadays, and what happened in the world make us to be serious in our spiritual life. I need something to be touched. I need to be happy. I want to be strong. I want to touch Jesus. I want to see Jesus. I'm coming to be different. I want to be spiritual. I want to be holy. I want to be a man of God. When we hear today the story of Saint Amba Boules Tamuhi and Saint Bishoy, to remind us we need to be like them. And I want to be like them. I don't want less than that. I want to separate myself from the world. You are here in the kingdom of God. Search for the king. The king is waiting for you. King is keeping great blessing. Don't miss the blessing, please. And be like idle towards the blessing. They insist to put him, and Jesus insist to heal him inside, not outer side. Not to say you are healed, said no, your sins are forgiven. But also, when we heal inside, always the outer will be given. Jesus said that. Ask for the kingdom of God, the rest will be given for you. So, Jesus wants that everyone today to be healed, everyone to be happy, everyone to be strong. Don't miss the chance. The first one, I will speak quickly, actually, the time, what St. Paul did. He went to Troas, and God opened the door for him, but he didn't use the door. He was worrying about the church of Corinth. But later on, when Titus came, met him in Philippi, he discovered what he was worrying about was not true. And devil does that in our life all the time. Make us worry. There is inner voice inside us always worrying us about future, our children, our work, about our health. And that is the inside voice of devil to worry. You reject him. I think if St. Paul had been knowing what happened in Corinthians and God opened him the door but he didn't use it, how much he was regretting for that. Please, when you have fears, worries, take it to the Lord and say, I trust you, Lord. Don't miss the open doors for you. Some people got open doors for them. Open doors for their future, their jobs. But because they have this driven by fear, always they don't use these chances. Always opportunity is there. God put opportunity and use it. Don't lose it. Don't say, I'm worried, I don't know what would happen, yes, I yet, nah. And that is the worst theology. When God opened door, kneel down and say, Lord, I know that from you, and I need you protect me. I will enter this door. I know that God is planning, God is dreaming for us. Much more we are dreaming for ourselves. Use the chances when you find the door open, and pass from it, and thank the Lord, and hold the hand of the Lord. Put your small hand in the mighty hand of the Lord to lead you for future. And remember, and God always wants to give the best for his children. He promised that in John 10. I'm coming to give you the best. Let us today think which door in front of me. Is it an open door? Is it an open door but I don't trust myself or trust God? pray and say, give me power, Lord, to pass. If the door is closed, is that God want to say something? Let us, Kida, when you are sitting, close your eyes and think. Let us, Kida, be honest for 2 minutes. Close your eyes and pray and say, Lord, I know how much you love me. I know how much you love me. How much you care for me. Lead me, Lord. I don't want my wisdom, my foolish wisdom to lead me or lead my life. I want you and your love and your care to lead me. I know there is green pastures for me. I know there is a beautiful destiny. You love us. You never open the door to let us to go and be broken. No, no. You open the door to bless us. Help us to trust you, Lord. And when the door is closed, show us why. Is that I forget my call? I forget my spiritual life? Is that there is a sin hidden in my life and you need me to repent? I need to repent, Lord. Help every one of us today to repent, return back to you. But show us in all of you are there and waiting us to fight, to struggle for our spiritual life, for our blessing. Don't allow us to be, Lord, like shattered by these problems or these challenges of devil, but rather to be strong and the fighter, to use the door, to find another door, but never be giving up. And all the time we need to see you and touch you. I pray blessing for everyone in the church. Blessing the Habibi Abuna Mikhail, Abuna Daniel, Sayyidina Amba Serafim, Kulla Habib. Make the day for us a blessed day, an open door for eternal life for heaven, that all of us can be blessed by the prayers of St. Mary and St. Mark, and St. Boles, Tamuhi, St. Pisho, all the saints. Amen.